Hello, this is the Watchdog, and welcome back to Fun with Watches. If watches weren't fun, you'd only need one. Today we have another unboxing video for you. This is a double unboxing. Yes, I know I promised you a triple unboxing, but the package that arrived that I thought was a watch was not. So this is just going to be a double today. Let's start with the wrist check. I'm wearing a U1001 GMT Batman. And Grogo's wearing my Chensky CX8848. The same two watches that were in my last video, except for swapped. Grogu asked Yoda's Force Ghost if he ever dated Yaddle. He said he took her on a boat ride on Dagobah, but said it didn't go very well. Yoda said that he couldn't help talking about himself and was droning on and on and on, and Yaddle got so bored that she eventually bailed on him, and he found himself up the creek without a Yaddle. Alright, we have two watches. I'm not sure what's in what, so let's just go in order I received them. I received this bigger one yesterday, and it's only bigger because it's packed in styrofoam. And I can't remember. I've had watches come in styrofoam before, and I can't remember what brand it was. So, it's probably the same brand. So, let's get the styrofoam open. And hopefully I don't get styrofoam all over the place and have to clean up, because that would be a pain. But I don't know why I'm even bothering cutting this neatly, because once you're cut open the styrofoam, it's pretty much useless. Okay, got the styrofoam out without making too big of a mess. Like that. See here. And we have a Debert. Oh, I'm so excited because this has an NH34 in it. This is the very first NH34 on my channel. Yes, I could have got a Pick-A-Nine design, but this Debert was cheaper. And my main concern was the movement. And I wanted to be able to review a movement, and I was kind of blowing my watch budget. So this one was only about $100. So I'm excited. Never had an NH34 before. And the whole AliExpress world's excited about the NH34 because it gives us an alternative to the DJ5833, which is so common on these automatic GMTs. And of course, an NH34 is made by Seiko, just has a better rep, or at least the company has a better rep. The movement just came out. But it makes me glad too that I didn't blow $500 on one of them Seiko 5s with an NH34 when it first came out, because that's a lot of money compared to $100 for this one. Yes, I know you're not getting the brand, but you're still getting the movement. It doesn't feel like a horrible watch either. It's got some heft to it. So it doesn't feel cheaply made. But yeah, here it is. An NH34. So, I don't know. Let me unscrew it. Let me wind it. And let's go ahead and put it in. Let's pop it out one. All right, here's the date moving. And there's the GMT hand moving. And this is a jumping GMT hand. It's not like the DJ5833 where it's a smooth GMT hand. This jumps by the hour, so this is going to be a lot easier to set when you change time zones. Alright, let's put it on the wrist and see what it looks like. Here's the watch and my 7.5-inch wrist. Looks like I can get 3 fingers, so I'm only be removing 1 to 2 links. So yeah, it's a nice looking watch though. Never heard of Debert before. But Once again, I was mainly concerned about the movement. Well, let's go to the next watch. But one more thing too, I just noticed it has a form of glide lock or glide lock like. So that's always nice when you have a Rolex style clasp, because otherwise the micro adjust is really difficult to use. All right, now let's go to the next watch. The thing about unboxing videos is you only have one chance to do it, because once it's out of the box, it's out of the box. And for some reason, I didn't hit the record button correctly, and I did most of my unboxing without the camera being on. So I got to start over, but it's already out of the bag, so I'm not going to pretend to put it back in the bag. So let's just open the box now. This is a Tianis, and this is an homage to a Rolex Daytona. Looks like a Paul Newman type. If you look at the subdials, it's got that distinct writing. And unlike the Pagani design that has the ceramic bezel or black bezel, this has the steel bezel, so it's a little bit closer to the actual Paul Newman. And I didn't take the blue off. Other than that, I took all the stickers off. And it did have a sapphire sticker, so this must have sapphire. So let's go ahead and unscrew the pushers and see if the chronograph works. Pretty sure this is a VK63. Huh, no, it's not a VK63 because it's ticking once a second. Huh, okay, not a VK63. Yeah, no instant snap there. Get the quick rewind. Huh, that's weird. Usually they're always VK63s if they're not a small second chronograph hand. Okay, well, I'd rather have a big chronograph hand than a little one. But it's kind of a shame that there's not a sub-second way. Nothing of timing sub-seconds. This only does seconds. All right, let's throw it on the wrist, see what it looks like. Here's the watch, unsized of my 7.5-inch wrist. Did I say unsized? Yes, I did, and look at that. It fits perfectly, so if you have a wrist bigger than 7.5, this will not work for you. You could always request extra links, I guess, from the seller and see what they say. But let me see, I didn't even look. Is it screw pins or is it push pins? Looks like we have push pins, not screw pins. So I don't know if you can find some oyster style with push pins and polished center links that would fit this. I don't know. But yeah, 7.5 is as big as you can do. Well, thank you for watching my unboxing video, and I will be back with another review. More than likely that Chensky that Grogu is wearing. Be sure and like and subscribe to my channel. Bye.